Poppin', y'all, it's your boy One Tree Rock. Like and subscribe. Give me a comment. Let's get it. Alright, bro, so we're a couple of days past the Philadelphia 76ers. Game 7 loss to the Atlanta Hawks. And I mean, I kind of calmed down. But I just wanted to start by saying, man, some people are not cut out to play for some cities. Like, for instance, like, even though Brian Dawkins is not originally from Philadelphia, he's a Philly guy. You get me? Allen Iverson, he's from Virginia, but he's a Philly guy. When we think about these guys, we don't think about where they came from. We think about where they played at. AI was the heart and soul of the Philadelphia 76ers for years. Brian Dawkins, the heart and soul of the Philadelphia 76ers for years. Joel Embiid will be the heart and soul of the Philadelphia 76ers for years. Well, Dawkins was an Eagle, I apologize, but y'all get where I'm coming from. So, Ben Simmons, he's not a Philly guy. I mean, some people just don't have that in them. Like us as a city, we're straightforward. We support you if you're giving it 100%. That's all we ask from you. Win or lose, just give it 100%. Just go hard. I mean, just show us that you care as much as we care. That's all we care about in this city. I mean, we're not going to win everything. You're not going to win every game. You're not going to win every series. But if you out there, you giving us your all, just like we come out there every day, we turn on our TVs every day. People pay their hard-earned money every day to go out there and watch y'all play. I mean, it got to be 50-50. And Ben Simmons is not a Philly dude. Just like Nelson Aguilar wasn't. Just like Carson Wentz really wasn't. I feel like with the Carson Wentz thing, though, I feel like toughness wasn't his problem. I mean, I felt like once the city started turning on him, like with us, like Philly will support you to the death. But once it get to that point where they start turning on you, it's over now. You gotta go somewhere else, because no matter what accomplishment you have after that, they're still going to paint a bad picture of you, especially the media and the fans. Because Carson Wentz was a horse. He was a big dude. He'll run through a brick wall for the team, but once you go mentally and the fans don't like you no more, it's over, man. Ben Simmons. Come on, bro. Like, it's like, you've been here 5 years, bro. You know how Philly is. You know this city. You live in the hardest in the city during the season. You know how this city is. Bro, we wouldn't have cared if you went 5 for 30 in the fourth quarter. Long as you going, you putting them shots up, you going hard, we'll give you a pass for that. That's how Philly is. He was shooting the ball. He just was missing. Why you think we ain't coming down hard on Joel Embiid and Tobias Harris? They played shitty in that game seven, but they actually looked like they wanted to win. Like, they actually was putting the shots up. They actually was, like, driving the ball. They was shooting. They was playing hard. They was playing defense. Like, it's like, bro, the mentality of this city is gritty. It's tough news. It's hard news. Like, we will never give you a pass if we see you not giving it your all. Never. Never. Like, McNabb gave it his all. But at the end of the day, people still love McNabb. Because McNabb, even though he went to them, five straight NFC championship games and he only went to one Super Bowl, McNabb played hard for us. He played hard. He probably grilled a little bit too much and all that. People ain't really like his attitude and all that. But he left it all on the field for the city every game. We love Michael Vick. Michael Vick wasn't even here that long, but Michael Vick showed you he wanted to be here. He wanted to play. He played hard. He put his body on the line every week, running, not sliding, trying to get the first down, everything. It's little stuff like that that make Philly fans love you. Nelson couldn't be here. D Dude was Nelson Aguilar was a good talent, believe it or not. No matter what y'all say about him, the drops and all that, Nelson Aguilar was a dog on the field. He was a dog on the field. He just he did the same thing Ben did. He just shut it down mentally. And after that, after you shut it down mentally, ain't nothing you can do no more. It's not gonna be easy to get out that slump. You drop a couple passes, now everybody calling you brick hands and stuff like that. Now, it's just in your head. You so focused on catching the football and so scared to drop the football that you actually making mistakes. You can't just go out there and play freely. So, it's dudes like that that is not Philly guys. Amen? Derek Coleman was... He never really averaged like a lot of points and stuff like that. But dude came to play every game. Eric Snow came to play every game. Aaron McKee came to play every game. Bro, it's like some people, they just stick in your city, bro. They just stick in your city. I mean, no matter where they came from, they could be from fucking Alaska. I apologize for cursing. They could be from Alaska, but they come to Philly. They give you that gritty mindset. Like dudes, like, it's crazy to me, bro. You gotta be here to understand what I'm talking about. I mean, you gotta actually be like Brian Dawkins is a Philly guy. He's a Philly guy. Even though he's from wherever he's from, North Carolina or something, I think. But he's a Philly guy. He got here, he made his mark. Brian Dawkins put it all on the field every game. Every game of his career. He never came up short. He probably missed a tackle or an interception or got beat in the coverage. But that's cool. That happens when you're playing hard and you just out there playing freely. Sometimes that happens. But Brian Dawkins loves the city of Philadelphia, and we love him. Allen Iverson loves the city of Philadelphia, and we love him. It's a difference, man. It's a difference. Like, it's Ben, you got to go, bro. You got to go. Because you had no heart at this point. To go 7 straight games and in the fourth quarter you only shoot 3 shots? 3? 4 straight games you didn't shoot, you didn't attempt a shot in the fourth quarter. Hey, bro, I don't think any city would be happy with that, but especially not. You can't come back to this team next year because it's not that you're not a you got good physical traits and stuff like that. But you don't have this. You don't have this. If you don't got this, you can't play here. And the city already turned their back on you, so it's a wrap. Elton Brand and Daryl Morgan might as well just trade you while you still got a little bit of value. Try to get like a nice player, a CJ McCollum or something like that. But you can't come back here and play, bro, because the fans, no matter what you do from now on, the fans already turned their back on you. Just like with Carson. Carson can come back here and play next year. The fans turned their back on him. It was going to be no matter what he did. Any little thing he did, any little layup, any little overthrown pass or fumble or something like that, they was going to crucify Carson. He couldn't come back here. Couldn't come back here next year. The same thing with you, Ben. Teammates basically throwing you under the bus. Coach basically throwing you under the bus. Like, basically saying you don't have what we all trying to confirm that you don't have no heart. I mean, but it is what it is, man. I'm tired of talking about the Ben Simmons thing. I mean, it's gonna be talked about until like a decision is made this year. He's either traded or I mean they decide to bring him back. But I mean, I'm kind of done with the Ben Simmons thing. I want to get into like my Eagles a little bit. And yo, football, like actual fan football, is back. I just purchased my tickets like I do every year, to go see the Eagles open practice. The first one would be August 8th. And I'm pumped up about it, man, because I be there every year. I used to be there every year before the pandemic. I take my family with me and stuff like that. Man, but football is actually back, bro. Like, it's like that football we watched last year, it was weird. Like, I ain't really feel, the season ain't feel real to me. It's like, no fans. You can hear all the play calls. You don't hear nobody screaming. It's like they try to pump noise into the drink, but it ain't really work. Like, but yeah, like football actually back now. I actually go see some games this year. I could I mean, go to my opening practices that I usually go to and watch the young boys do, watch the team do their thing, like little scrimmages and stuff. Like, if y'all never went to one of the open practices, it'd be lit, yo. Y'all should try it one day. Like, tickets on sale right now, and they only $10. I mean, they're only $10. Grab a ticket for you and your family. Go out, watch the Eagles practice and stuff like that. They be giving away gifts. I mean, the concession stands be open. Like, it's a good joint. It's a good joint. So, and I want to talk a little bit about Coach Gannon. We don't really know a lot about Coach Gannon. But all the stuff we're hearing, like, in-house in front of players and stuff, they love him. They run through the brick wall for dude. And I feel like if they love him, I'm going to support him, too, until further notice. You know what I mean? Still, until I actually see his work on the field. They love Nick Sirianni. I'm going to support him because nothing better than hearing it in-house. Because there's some dudes on the team that'll actually tell you how they're feeling, like a Jason Kelce, a Brandon Graham. Like, people like that, they'll tell you how they actually feel about a person. Like, they won't hide it, like, just for, like, media purposes and stuff. They'll actually tell you how they feel. I mean, who else like that? Lane Johnson, he'll tell you how he actually feel. So, it's like, everything that coming back from the Eagles, like, in-house is positive right now. So, and then it's really, like, everything right now just in slow motion because ain't really a lot to talk about with the Philadelphia Eagles except for, like, stuff that already been discussed. All right, so, man, I'm liking what I'm hearing so far, and I can't wait to, like, see him practice in person, man. I can't wait. All right, it's, like, football season is back, y'all. Like, man, but, yeah. And I still want to discuss a little bit of the Fletcher Cox thing. Like, it's just mind-boggling how y'all feel like y'all should get rid of this dude. Like, dude damn went to the Pro Bowl damn near every year he's been in the league. Still demands double teams by 85% of the time. Still gets damn near, like, top three most pressures in the NFL. Even though the sack's not there, if you could pressure a quarterback and move him off his spot, that's just as good as a sack. Or you chase him into another person, then the other person get the sack. That's just as good as a sack. Y'all got to understand this. Y'all got to understand this. That's just as good as a sack. That's just like me blitzing up the middle. I'm a linebacker. I'm blitzing up the middle. The quarterback run to the outside, and my DN get a sack. That's basically as good. It's basically like I got the sack, too. I chased him. I forced the play. That's just like a linebacker tipping a pass in the air in the corner, and the safety intercepted, or a corner tipping a pass in the air and the safety intercepted. You did your job. You did your job. You're not going to always get the pick. You're not going to always get the sack. You're not going to always get the tackle. But if you could come, if you're a corner and you could turn the outside play back up the field and the linebacker come field and make the tackle, you did your job. Y'all got to look past the stats sometimes. Y'all got to look past the stats, bro. Because stats is not everything. Stats not everything. Like when Timmy Jernigan was here, our 2017 year, he didn't get a lot of sacks, but dude had hella plays on in the run game, and he pressured the quarterback and made him run, and then Derek Barnett got a sack. Brandon Graham got a sack. Fletcher Cox got a sack. Jordan Hicks, Michael Kendricks, they all was getting sacks just off based off the pressure straight up the middle. Because the best way, the easiest way to get to the quarterback is straight up the middle. And if your DN's containing the right way, he's going to run right into him. A lot of y'all don't know the ins and outs of football. Like, that's just like if your O-line not blocking, your running back's going nowhere. If your O-line not blocking, your quarterback don't have enough time to get it to your receivers down the field. Everything works hand-in-hand. Everything. Everything works hand-in-hand. Kicking. If your long snapper not getting the ball back there to you, you can't kick the ball. If your holder not holding the ball right, you can't kick a field goal. Like, everything works hand-in-hand. Y'all can't just put that on Fletcher Cox. Y'all can't just put it on Fletcher Cox. He's fighting through double teams, triple teams sometimes. And he's still getting back there, getting his hand on the quarterback or forcing him out the pocket. Come on, y'all got to learn football. Y'all got to learn football. But, yeah, man. Like I said, it's slow right now. I mean, until training camp start. I think training camp start late July. We will actually have some preseason games this year. So it's about to be a good joint, yo. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. This is your boy One Trey Rock Mate.